Hello brothers and sisters in Christ and fellow YouTubers. This is going to be just a quick introduction prior to Zeph's latest podcast and talk in regards to suicides. Just to let you know, I made this prior to listening to Zeph's podcast, so the litmus test will be how this lines up with Zeph's talk, which will be following. As you know from listening to Zeph's podcast over the past week or so, that we are in a period of very heavy witchcraft during this holiday season. The attacks have been heavy and everyone has been feeling them in one form or another. I kind of compare these attacks like a roller coaster in which there are ups and downs. One day is hard and the next day the pressure is momentarily relieved. It is quite possible that these attacks were related to ELF waves. ELF stands for extra low frequency. It's a frequency which is below your level of hearing and below the point or level in which you can physically feel it, but it does exist. Many years ago, I ran across articles about ELF and ultra-low frequencies. All of these can have major effects on your physical and mental health. Frequencies at different levels can cause or trigger a list of myriad psychological symptoms such as anxiety, anger, fear, aggression, depression, hopelessness, agitation, nervousness, sadness, and etc. I also know that there is a generalized fear being felt, especially by the Lord's saints, and that you just can't quite put your finger on it, and that you feel that shit is about to hit the fan. I just want to quickly let you know that the good Lord feels your pain and fear and is here to comfort you with his presence and peace. Yep, I've been experiencing these roller coaster emotions too, and want to reassure you that things will eventually settle down. In the meantime, keep your chin up as you can, best you can, by 1. Taking an occasional deep breath and exhaling. 2. Talking to someone about your fears. 3. Going deep into the Bibles and studying your Bibles. 4. Find an activity which you have enjoyed in the past to use as a distraction. And 5. Turn off and tune out the news. Part of our fears come from the fact of not knowing when the powers that be will drop the shoe upon the people, and also knowing or feeling that we have no control. Remember this, God is in control all of the time, and he will walk you through this, believe me. I've been through my rodeos like this and even supernatural death-defying experiences over the years, and the Lord has always brought me through and made me even stronger. So rejoice, my brothers and sisters in Christ. May this message be a blessing to you and for you and bring you some peace and comfort. Peace and many blessings. Good day.
Greetings in the name of the Most High. I got to show up right now. I got to be here. Look, I know it's hard. I can feel it. And that's what I have to go on. The Lord popped me out of bed and said, you got to get on that air right now. So I'm here. And this is the Zeph Report, Zeph Daniel, your sometimes wayward host. But I've been, you know, kind of on duty here with this. As I explained to you before, the highest spiritual warfare is on these at this time between, say, the solstice and the new year. It doesn't matter what the satanic calendars or the witchcraft calendars say. That just, you know, it's disinfo. I don't care if there's 1,000 of them that say that. This is the time. And so, for a lot of you, what that means is in your lives, they tank. There's a feel bad, beam, if you will, going around right now for almost all people, especially targeted in the United States. And though it's not affecting us all, because I'm pretty much intact, but I'm intact so I can do this, because I'm having to reach out, because I understand that you're feeling really, you know, what's happening is that this witchcraft, this power, this the rituals, the kind of unified voice to overthrow America. All this stuff is kind of tied in with this witchcraft, and it's hitting many of you. And what happens is, you know, so if you're a targeted individual and you're having trouble with all that, and it's very scary stuff, it's going to ramp up like there's no tomorrow. If you've fits of depression and drug habits, drinking habits, whatever, it's going to flare up. If you've got voices in your head whispering to you at night, fetishes, whatever, it's going to ramp up. If you've got, you know, if you're just troubled, then you're going to feel an increase in that troubling. And this is just a blanket. You know, it's kind of across the board around the world. I mean, it's just unfortunate that so much power. But again, when you put the birth of Christ in the midst of the pagan holiday, the solstice, which has 2 weeks of, you know, hoopla, whatever, you're talking about them trying to turn it into the most powerful or derive the most power out of that as they can. So if you're a lamb, you know, then obviously you're gonna have to be prayed up. You're gonna have to be doing spiritual warfare. You're gonna have to understand the Bible. You're gonna have to, you know, really kind of bear down on it, because it's just in your face, and it will subside after the new year. It's already subsiding a little bit from the full moon. You know, full moon on Christmas, that's just gonna be off the charts. It's going to be the worst you ever felt, you know, but it should be, it's going to lift. Your suicidal thoughts are going to lift. That's right. Do not kill yourself. Do not even go there for right now, because in like a matter of 2 minutes, it's going to lift and you're going to go, wow, why was I feeling that? Because it wasn't you. Someone else put that there. That's why you're feeling that. And because you've been open to it, because you feel bad about yourself, you're susceptible to those kinds of beams, which are spells coming in. This time of year, the suicide spell, if you will, is mass marketed. It's blanketing the earth. So that, you know, it's almost like a force of nature, so that basically the weak among us are culled. You know, and it's you know, God allows it to happen for whatever reason. I know that all the motivations of God are all unbelievably amazing, so amazing I can't comprehend them. But the way it looks to me through the satanic lens, in other words, all life on earth is through a satanic lens, through a matrix, it looks the opposite, so it's going to look bad. But the suicide beam, which is, when I say beam, electronics, spell casting, the circle and the pentagram, ritual sacrifice, human sacrifice, orgiastic ritual, whatever, all of it designed to raise the power to get you. And in whatever way or style that you get manifestings happening, or, you know, some of you are going to be head-to-head with demons, and things like that, you know, really kind of things that you couldn't describe to anybody, or they would think you're completely insane. If you had a thing with the abduction thing, that's going to come back. But only briefly, because you're too smart for this. You understand it's someone else doing it to you, so you're going to say, hey, screw you, and you're gonna ride it out like riding a storm out. Remember REO Speedwagon? Ride in the storm out. You're going to ride it out. Now that's what you're going to do, okay? No ifs, ands, or buts. That's what you're going to ride it out, because you're going to feel better, because it's going to lift. And I pray in Jesus' name right now to give you understanding of this rhema, understanding of this word right now in Jesus' name, understanding of the way things work right now in Jesus' name. No more confusion in Jesus' name right now on you, on me, everyone. Come on. So you'll stand down. you will stand down and cut it out now because it's not you. That's why. You want to kill yourself? You do it, not somebody else. That's more like murder. And then, you know, and you have the power over that. You want to do it, you know, you think you've got good reasons, then you on your own do it, not being semi-possessed or taken over by this beam, spell, whatever, and then it's making you act in a way that you don't usually act. Let it be your idea. No, because see, I say that because it will never be your idea, because in your right mind, that's just not the way you roll. All this is demonic, you know. So the witches, what they do is they stoke up all the demonic spirits, right? And they send them your way, my way, all over the place. This is the time. And, you know, they're in cahoots with Satan, obviously, because, I mean, what's that? Is that benevolent witchcraft? No, it's not really, is it? But they justify it by saying, well, it only affects those who are resistant to what? It's to their dark lord, is who it is, to the god of the earth, who don't want that connection to the earth. That because, and they think it's for the greater good that they get rid of you. Because they're misguided, because they work for the enemy, they work for evil, yet they try to appear as angels of light. Somebody had a photograph of orbs when people are praying, and then we've been having discussions of these orbs because this time of year you'll see them a lot, right? Look, I have confirmation. Anyone worth their salt in whether it be the dark arts or sorcery or anything like that will agree with me about this week. And they'll say, that's right, it's not written down anywhere. That's right. Because they don't want to ever admit that it has something to do with Jesus Christ. That's why you're never going to see it. Because they're never going to admit it. Because they're going to go, well, we were around way before. And but they understand on a kind of a collective basis that there's something, that the power of the Lamb is really the power of God, you know, and then that it is God. And it is God coming in the flesh to basically be sacrificed to set the world free. And it's free of what? That witchcraft, for one thing. Hey, I got him throwing stuff at me all day long. Why am I not completely, well, people would say, but you are broken in a million pieces, Zeph. It's not like you got away with anything. Yeah, well, that's right. Well, I'm also laughing right now, and you're going to knock it off. Hey, you know, put the crack pipe down, meaning whatever you're thinking, whatever you're going to do, you know, it's delayed. That's an order. It would be a shame to say on somebody's epitaph, you know, well, this person lost control of themselves, so some other entity came in and killed them. So, gee, isn't that sad? When in fact you have control of yourself right now. So, you know, whatever, it's over. Go, stop, go home, go to bed, you know, it's done. And you'll ride it out like the rest of us. Hey, everybody's, you know, everybody hurts. You don't have a, it's amazing how many lambs get into this pity party thing. You know, yes, you're not favored in the world. Yes, you're laughed at as being, you know, an idiot. Yes, blah, 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 until their system doesn't work. And then all of a sudden they're the deer in the headlights and you're the one that, you're the wise man, and you're the one with the power. But until that day comes, they're going to behave like that. Are you going to let them and their stupid behavior based on total ignorance affect what you do? I think you might try not to have that thing affected. Now, I'm not trying to come down on you. I'm just saying, you know, I mean, obviously, the Lord got me out of there, and he told me what was up, and I'm addressing you right now. More than one? More than one. Look, again, it's like a storm. It passes through. It's not you. It's being done to you. If it were your thoughts and your process and you had a justification for whatever you're going to do, I mean, nothing I could do to stop you. But in this case, it isn't you. And I pray it lifts just for a second so you can see. It has to pass through. It can't just be lifted. Well, in some cases, it can be cast out, but now it's not the time. This is going on worldwide, and it's passing through this week. And there's just nothing you can do except protect yourself and pray up and say, well, I pray protection on you in the name of Jesus. Amen. That this spell will not touch you. Amen. In Jesus' name. That it'll pass through you and you won't even believe what you were contemplating doing because it wasn't you. And you're going to tell me, you know, Zeph, it wasn't even my thoughts. That's right. Now, whenever you have thoughts that are not your own, you're behaving in a way that's not really you. Somebody else is doing that to you, okay? Just so you have a little litmus test so you can check yourself. Well, you know, I told Trish yesterday, I said, I don't know if I can do these F reports because I'm not a very good person. I know people that are much gooder than me, you know what I mean? But maybe it's because, I'm really not qualified to preach to anybody in terms of, you know, I struggle with my own behavior and my own sinning, like I say, and repenting and, you know, trying to stay out, you know, just like other people I know. I'm no better than any of my friends, you know, and they're not so great either in terms of being perfect. So I'm not really qualified to preach at you. You know, because I'm, like today, I'm struggling with stuff too. You know, I may not blather it all out on the air because, I mean, you get plenty from me, but you don't have to have every little detail, do you? Yes, we want every little detail. Well, people want you to shame yourself, obviously, publicly, and flog yourself, and I'm not going to do that because I'm just not going to let, you know, I recognize that I fall short. So, you know, I'm no better than you that I was just talking to regarding your kind of based on the idea that you don't understand, you feel it's all your process. It's not. Not this week, no. And I predicted it last week. Why didn't you pay attention then? You know, I mean, it sounds like I predicted it and no one did anything about it in terms of being prayed up. And you all went, you know, headlong off the cliff. And I told you that was going to happen this week. And then, you know, now you're acting like you never heard the word before. I mean, you were told what would happen this week. And now it's like there are thousands of people that, you know, are just completely undone right now. And it's like, where was the preparation in the word? Where was a day of fasting? Where was anything? Just, you know, keeping a vigilant awareness. Where was that? What happened to any of that? You guys all just walked off the cliff. You know, it's just like, yep, there's machine gun fire out there, so you better really take cover. And you just went walking out single file right into the battlefield. You know, I mean, I don't, see, that's what I don't understand about this F report. If I give you a warning, it's not like an idle warning. I told you this time of year, these days right now are the worst, are the most powerful in terms of suicides and, you know, battles and war. You see what's going on in this, the whole Middle East thing, and, you know, the tensions ramping up, and, you know, it's, and 2016, you know, 2015 was much worse than 2014. Especially in terms of spiritual warfare, much, much harder. And the next year is going to be harder because these people, they, you know, this, and these demons, they have got the bit between their teeth and they see victory and they're going to pull out all the stops. And part of that is to try to get you to self-destruct. That way the blood's not on their hands. I mean, they can take credit for your sacrifice, but then, you know, secretly, right? They figure they're going to beam everybody and see what falls off. And that becomes a blood sacrifice to Satan done by them. But you think it's you. You see what I mean? You were duped by witchcraft. Oh, it's highly technological. You don't even understand. It's like all the symbols of the pentagrams and all that tie into very hardcore high-tech stuff in another dimension. And it's you cannot fight it without Jesus Christ. It's like people trying to fight being abducted, you know. Being the whole abduction thing is demonic possession, demonic oppression, demonic a demonic takeover in your life, isn't it? Being abducted, having sex with demons that you think are aliens, then, you know, giving birth to babies, thinking you had a baby stolen from you, but it's a hybrid between alien and human, and eventually they're going to launch these on the earth. A lot of this is just a dream world fantasy. You know, these women are not having any sex with aliens and going off anywhere. It's all basically in the mind and in the dream world. And that's where these things reside. But I mean, I can talk till I'm blue in the face, and they're still going to say, they're out there. I don't, you know, and they say, well, where are they? You know, gee, you know, it's like you're not looking in the right place. They're all around us, is where they are. They're not out there somewhere. And all these demons are energized right now. And let's just think back. Okay, we had this. I'm going to have to talk a little bit about the geopolitical thing, but I'm just trying to look. I may not have the best bedside manner, but I'm telling you're to stand down. The Lord is telling through me to you to tell you to stand the F down because the Lord tells it to you like that. He's talking to you. And I cannot put it in any stronger terms. And, you know, you don't want to invite total damnation to your soul, do you? Oh, that would be better than this? Oh, really? Are you sure? I don't think so. I mean, no love, no light, no respite. Nothing like that. You're being told to stand down, you have to obey, just like I have to obey. We all have to obey the Lord. Look, he obviously knows because he got me, you know, out of the rack and into the microphone and into the system right here, and I'm here. You know, the Lord knows of your pain. He says it will lift. It will lift. Have you been prayed up? I pray it lifts right now in Jesus' name. At least it's going to lift a little so you have some running room, and then it's going to just pass through. But you're going to have to, you know, gird up so you can walk through this. It's no big deal. It just happens to be the highest spiritual warfare of the century right now. This week, and you know, you just need to be prayed up. That's all you needed before. And then you walk through. It's nothing you can't handle. Well, you know, all this began, may I note, with a pity party. And what I had, every pot I've had has been addressing all of your issues. You know, trying to you know, be, you know, forewarning and trying to be up ahead of the curve there. And I feel I have been. But I mean, I need you to do your part as well. Not just peruse through the podcast like this is just another, when there's something supernatural taking place in communication, to just slough it off as, you know, something else you'll see on YouTube later with someone else will have their opinion. You can't do that. If you receive it, then you have to act on it. Look, I'm not trying to scold you. I'm just saying, you know, it was for your benefit that you were given a heads up. And now look how quickly you've descended to this point. It's not just one. It's obviously a whole bunch of people we're talking to that have, you know, I know. And some are going through some really horrific stuff. I mean, it's unbelievable, you know. And at the same time, the Lord wants us to be submissive, you know, as lambs, you know, to submit to Him. Vengeance is His, saith the Lord. Or, you know, just showing us that we don't have the power to, we're meek. We don't have the power to overturn the world system, to go head to head against witchcraft or anything. We don't have any power to do any of that stuff. There's a lot of power in witchcraft. a tremendous amount of power this week. I mean, it's unbelievable. It's like beyond, you know, it's like, you know, 100,000 jet engines. You know, it's very powerful, and it has a very powerful effect. And one way you detect it is to see if you're behaving or acting or otherwise, you know, are there symptoms manifesting and old things manifesting? I don't care if it's ghosts, demons, you know, a demonic whispering within your ear, whatnot, temptation to old things you thought you were through already. You know, just any number of things. The whole idea is to weaken you down into that, because once you go ahead and commit to whatever, you know, and allow yourself to be a victim of any of those things, then that door is wide open, and now in comes the spell, and it's like, kill yourself. Harm yourself. What's the use? There's no point in going on. And that's one thing if it's coming from you, but it's coming from outside of you. That's the whole point. That's why we have warnings. That's why we, you know, did what we did with the Zeff report. That's why you were aware of all this ahead of time, so you could gird up and so the Lord, you know, the Lord just wants to walk us through it right now, right? He just wants to walk us through it. It's like being lifted. You can feel it lifting right now. You can feel it lifting, and, you know, daylight's around the corner. I'm sorry, but, you know, this week, especially with the full moon on Christmas, that's just, you know, that's got to be the most powerful day of the year right there. So every kind of manifestation that could happen will happen. I'm surprised we haven't seen more UFO sightings during this week, because I would think that there'd be plenty, although I haven't been watching it, I haven't been keeping up. Now, I did start up, I have a channel that I had for like music and music videos. I know you hate that, so. But I did do a screencast. I did get the software for screencasting, which is, can also do like a, you know, video of a talk if I do one. And so I did one yesterday about the costumes of ISIS, and then I wound up with Ramadi, the Ramadi propaganda. Here's what I got in the spirit on that, okay? And this is, you just have to verify this or wait a few months till and it'll be confirmed then. Or it may not be, but I mean, you know, I'm not ever going to say I'm 100% perfect, but I will say this. What I got in the spirit was this. ISIS was told to leave and they left. And they made it look like a big victory because Obama was melting down in the polls on foreign policy. So he needed a victory. So so since he's the commander in chief of ISIS, he just, you know, they just went ahead and did it because they own ISIS and ISIS will do what they're told. There was no battle there. So that's what I got. Oh, they're going around prancing around with victory. And we see some buildings on fire and different things like that. But really, it's just more of the same deception. I'm sorry. It's a propaganda victory for Obama, trying to get people to think, well, see, he's doing something. We have Ramadi back. You know, the war in Oceania is going fine. They're pulling that same, you know, 1984 stuff on you. And I'm just hoping that you're semi-aware. I don't know. But I also showed the costumes. But because I included Ramadi, I was way ahead of the curve on my screencast, because no one out there in the alternative news community was really dealing with Ramadi yesterday. That was really mainstream. They'll be dealing with it now. But I was out there. I thought my video was a bit dated, and then I realized, hey, no, I talked about Ramadi. So, and I gave my take on it. The most amazing things, I showed some pictures of what I was describing about the costumes of ISIS and the fact that they all wear these, you know, all have the matching, you know, ski masks. And I'm like, if you're a state doing business as a state, distributing oil and all that, you don't have your people wear masks unless you don't want us to see who's under those masks, that they're really mercenaries, you know, which if we start finding that out, then of course, you know, and the left is all for ISIS. I explained this in my video too. I mean, they want ISIS to come here and be assimilated. They want ISIS to be Obama's private army. And it's like, I got news for you idiots on the left. That is his private army. You know, so he goes away and there's a victory, looking like he's not there, but it's a victory to his with the Ramadi thing. If ISIS, these are the same Iraqis that were giving up their weapons and running away from ISIS, scared to death. They suddenly beat the crap out of him in Ramadi and with a few little help from a few soldiers. No, they fled. ISIS fled because they were told to flee. You know, so I did a couple of bombing runs and whatnot, and there's no ISIS around, so they claim victory, put a flag up. Big BFD, man. If you run ISIS, you could always pretend you're not going to have the soldiers killing ISIS. You're going to have them retreat. If you're running ISIS, you're going to have these kind of mock battles, you know, which now the Russians are accusing the Americans of having, quite accurately. America is just so bad. Worst country ever at this point. And, you know, and the reason it's still here is because the left wants it gone. You know what I mean? So it's going to still be here. And we have a delicious thing happening. But I want to get back to the reason I got on the air here was not to talk about Ramadi. I covered that in a video. And I'm not sure what I'm going to do here. I have a Spreaker account, too, that I'm looking at seriously, and not that I'm going to have you come over and get onto that feed, but I'm looking at how I could use Podbean and Spreaker together, because Spreaker has a distro into YouTube so that you would get these automatically on YouTube. I know that Roger does a great job, you know, blogging our talks onto YouTube, and he also blogs Brother Thomas. And that's another thing I want to do is get Brother Thomas's predictions for the year and see what he's up to. So all that I've kind of, it has to be in the works, as well as I got a, you know, a dozen music projects. And all the music, I guarantee you. Well, what's the most radical thing I've ever done musically was my Merry Christmas song. And if you haven't heard it, shame on you. Seriously, shame on you. Total shame on you. The Merry Christmas song, I sent it to my friend in California too. He loved it. He was like, he just... you know, he was like, I just can't, you know, I just love it because it's so politically correct. It's like the most radical thing you can do is wish people a Merry Christmas. So I just said it over and over and over. And I sung pretty well. I've, you know, people tell me. And they like the chord, the D-flat key I was in. And they like all that. And they like the chords I chose. And, you know, they like it. They like the whole thing. Well, it's not the most polished piece, but I had to get it out in a day. But it sounds like a standard Christmas song that you'd hear on your radio, you know, that would be in there with Nat King Cole, and then this would come on. It wouldn't be, it would flow on, and then on to the next one with Frank Sinatra or whatever, or with Bing Crosby, you know. It could actually be in that flow, you know, mixing it with some modern tunes as well. But it just says Merry Christmas over and over, and over and over, and over and over. And, you know, I meant it so that you all could get it and play it for your families and whatnot, because it was a real Christmas song that was produced from a non-satanic situation, you know what I mean, kind of outside the system. So I thought, you know, hey, this'll just a sweet Merry Christmas song. And you know what's nice? It really does bring people together. People from, you know, you don't have to. And I proved my own point. I proved my point that here's the point. That I could wish Merry Christmas to people of different faiths, of different beliefs. And I say that in the song. I say, it doesn't matter what you believe. I'm wishing you Merry Christmas to send joy your way. And you know what? They all receive it. People of Muslims and Jews and different people, they all receive it the same way. They're not, right? It's like, that's what it was meant. That's what it was. It's so frustrating, you know, the PC police and these awful people. They're so, I mean, I try not to look at them when I go into town. I try to avoid, I try to turn away. But at times I have to interact with them, you know. And I just, it's like the most unpleasant thing in the world for me. I thought we would blast that Merry Christmas song out and it would go viral, be on video, be everywhere, you know. And I'm like, wow, you guys are really have no morale. You know, I thought we were really, you know what I mean? There was something you could really use in your spiritual warfare, and it's sweet too. It would have been great, but the moment's passed now. Well, I don't know. It's like I keep showing up here, and I wonder, I wonder. I know that I'm here today because of the suicide beam. And since it was so serious, I had to get on the microphone, tell you not only God's stopping you from that right now, he's just with a supernatural force that you can't fight, he's stopping you and showing you that the thoughts are not your own. Your action isn't even your own. It's you were basically almost taken out by the witches. Witch has high technology in other dimensions, you know, beaming and aiming it all at you and all that. So I just wanted you to know that the Lord pulled your butt out of the fire there right now. And if you have any thought at all, you have, here's what the thought you should have. Thank you, Father. You saw me and you got Zeph to talk and then boom, you know. It was like it all worked together the way it's supposed to. You're not being blamed for not heeding the warning last week. That's me doing that. I said, but it's not like you weren't told. See, this is what blows my mind. You were told it was going to be like this. But that's not the Lord talking. The Lord is like, I have rescued you. It is the Lord who rescues you. It's the Lord who saves you. It's the Lord who is looking out for you. It's the Lord who's intervened on your behalf. So you can now rest assured and have the confidence that we're all, you know, in locked arms, we're walking through this thing. You know, it's not worse for you than anybody else. You've got the Lord. What more do you want? You've got the inheritance of all the cosmos and everything that's ever been created is yours. So just, you know, start acting like it, like a son or a daughter of the Most High God, please. Start acting like it. You're entitled. Just, you know, flaunt it a little bit. That's what I'm doing. I mean, but, you know, again, I'm... When it comes to lining up with the Word at times and the way I, you know, the way I struggle along and, you know, I just am not a good model, you know, Christian. I'm not a good model. So, you know, you just have to use me as, you know, but God does what he does, you know, through me. I don't know why that happens. There's other people I know that are just way better of a human than me, you know. And I'm not going to beat myself up. See, that's the other thing. They would love to get me to do that, to feel guilty. No, I'm aware of it. I've said it. I'm working on it. But feeling guilty, whip me, beat me, no. Let the evangelical church do that. No. They just fake it anyway. They pretend to line up with the Word. But, you know, we don't really line up all the time. We have, you know, things that were done and patterns and are hardwired in certain ways that just will never line up. And, you know, I can't be, you know, the great example for you to follow, but I can speak something to you that is coming from, you know, our Father. That can do. But there's no guarantee that it will happen again. You see, that's the thing with the Lord. There's no guarantee that about anything with him, you know. I don't know. I just know that, I mean, give some credit to the Lord because he yanks me out of bed and it's like, okay, the suicide beam. Huh? Applause, please. I mean, is that amazing or what? And give some credit for being able to have almost like a two-way conversation here. How could I do that? That's beyond psychic. There's no explanation for that except that we're in the same spirit. We're in the same realm, the same dimension, and there's a power over us that's making it possible for this to happen. Give it up for that, please. You know, give them a shout of praise, please, because that's not natural, and it doesn't happen in the churches, and it doesn't happen. This is special. It's happening here, now, with you. So you got really no excuse. You got to get up on your feet and get cleaned up. Have some coffee, whatever. Get going. You know, you're going to put this day behind you right now. It's over. It's in the past. It's gone. You just walk free now. Knowing that the rest of the week, there's stuff coming from the left and the right. You ain't going to feel that great. But you will sing and dance and twirl around again. You know, life, there are storms, you know, and we live in a good versus evil situation. So we have to take the good with the bad. You know, it's not going to be every day is just, you know, roses and cotton candy and stuff. You know, it's not a dessert for every meal. You know, it's just that you take the good with the bad, and we're all involved. I mean, you know, we're here, right? So you're subject to it. Some have harder struggles than others, and then it just depends. You know, the Lord, who am I to judge anyone else or be upset with anyone else if they have it easier than me or harder than me or whatever? It's just, you know, at times I've had it harder than other people. They've had it harder than me. It goes back and forth. You know, we just got to cling to the Lord. That's all. You know, Jesus got really mad when, you know, Peter was questioning him about John. You know, what's going to happen to him? I mean, I know I got to, you know, be crucified. Is he getting away? You know, and it was like, well, what difference does it make what I do with him versus what I do with you? I'm dealing with both of you. I'm paraphrasing, but I mean, that's kind of the gist of it, right? You know, the way that I'm being handled versus the way you're being handled, if we start comparing ourselves, then your Christian walk, your walk in Christ is over that day. It's over that second you do that. Quit comparing. You know, comparing is your perception anyway of things you may not perceive accurately. Quit comparing. Well, when I start comparing, like on the internet, you can't help but compare. Everyone compares everything. So what do I notice? I start getting bummed out. I start getting depressed. I start feeling lousy. I start feeling old. I start feeling like I don't belong. I start feeling all kinds of things. And those are little doorways. And then guess who comes running on in? The critters. And I'm just telling you that, you know, this week it's just an onslaught. And that's why I'm saying that I'm kind of surprised with all this on the ground here and all this interdimensional activity with the demons being conjured by the witches and the powers that be. I'm kind of surprised that there aren't more UFO sightings and orb sightings. There was an orb picture in a church, in a, you know, I'm supposing an evangelical prayer was going on in an evangelical kind of little church. And there are orbs on the ceiling. I have not made a conclusion, but where there are orbs, there are, you know, sometimes red flags for me, because that's always represented witchcraft. We had that back in the 90s. Trish and I had one come through the house and, you know, come to the bed and observe and then go back out the wall. I mean, but it was getting kind of in our face, but that's witchcraft. Now, can there be orbs that are angels and stuff? I don't know. These were all on the ceiling in this church meeting, and they did not have video footage. They had a still of it. And as you look at them, they're kind of like UFO lights in the sky. I don't know what to make of it, and I have drawn no conclusion one way or the other. It's good that people are praying together. Yes, absolutely. But what if it's a wicked church and they're praying, but it's a hypocritical situation? Could there be orbs there from the other side? You're darn right there could be. Okay? So, you know, I don't know. I don't know the status of it. I was going to do a little video about that, but then there's just one still photo. It's really not enough to make a video out of. And we don't know who the players are. We're just to take it on, you know, on face value that these are angels. I think that's a mistake to just assume that, because they're balls of light that are supernatural happening in a prayer meeting. That they could be conjured also from the people there in the prayer in some way. You know, it could be from witches who are in the midst of running the church there. If that's the case, you know, it's something that would be possible that way. So I can't, you know, I'm not saying it is that. I'm just saying I can't really, you know, take it that seriously. But if we start seeing orbs showing up in every church meeting around every prayer group, then I'm going to really have to pray on that. I'm going to have to look at that you know, seriously. Because, you know, angels manifest too. I've seen them in human form. I've interacted with them. And then God hides them so well. It's like they're all familiar with everything, and they're just like, you've seen them. And then when they leave, it's like they were never there in the first place, but they had a car, they had a suit on, they had a girlfriend in the car or whatever. It just seemed like a normal thing. And then you realize they don't exist anywhere. Yeah, so you see, that's very profound. That's not some orb of, you know, orb. That's a like flesh and blood situation. And there's no way it really happened. It's they're in another dimension, whatever. They come into this one like they've been here forever. And they just fit in. And then when they're gone, you realize they haven't been here at all. And that, you know, they don't exist anywhere. But you did have an interaction with them. And they did know things about you. They did come to tell you a message. Angels are messengers. And they told you a direct message. Don't worry about this one that's passed away. Don't, that's happened to me. Don't, you know, and then, yeah, then they leave, supposedly. Now, could it be someone who was sent by God that had a message from the angelic realm or from God to give to me? Yes, that could have been it, if that person had a terrestrial foundation. But I've seen it both ways. And I had a friend, the same thing, that would have avoided a traffic accident. He was on the side of the road, you know, heading towards Simi Valley. Back in those days, the freeway to Simi Valley from the valley was this, you know, very almost desolate, because it was out in the valley. You know, there's just no cars on it. It was like a new freeway that didn't get used that much. So he's on the side of the road, the car broken down, and there's nothing. It's just this empty freeway. You know, lit and everything like a freeway, but just like nothing around. And some car stops, and that looks like a car out of another time zone, you know, like a Rolls Royce from 1935 or something. And there was a gal in it. And she, you know, she said she was there to take him wherever he needed to go. And he got in, and she took him to he was going to his parents' house out there. So she took him there. And then, you know, she just disappeared. She just kind of drove away. But the way she was dressed and the way the car was, it was from another time zone, like 1930s. I don't know how you're going to read that, but he actually got transported to where he needed to go. And this person showed up in the middle of, I mean, I think you've all had kind of experiences like that, right? It's just, there's no explanation. They obviously came in here from another time zone. And that's why I say the past is not set in stone. The past is as fluid as the future. In fact, the past and the future don't really exist, but they are malleable from our perspective. That's why, you know, you can read interesting things in history books, but don't believe that's the history, right? Because it changes. And you can go back in the same book and you can see, no, I thought it said this. Well, it did say that, but now it says this. And everything is like that. Everything is completely nothing in stone, so fluid, nothing contiguous, nothing. You live in a supercharged, supernatural atmosphere where anything can happen anytime. That should give us all a lot more hope. And God is in charge of it all. And you're his kid. And you're, you know, so it's just, we're not here to just suffer and die, folks. Yes, we have sorrows because, you know, if you have a heart, you look at this world, you're going to cry. Yeah. That, you know, if only, I mean, and there's all these political groups looking at, you know, this group or that group and say, oh, if only they weren't here. Oh, if only they weren't here. If we could just get rid of them. And I've done the same thing, you know, with the godless left. I've done the same thing, you know. But it's false. I'm here to confess that that's false. It's false direction. it's we're here, and if any one group was taken away, it wouldn't matter. We still have what's within us to deal with, and what's within us is what's projecting outward as our government, as our society, as our, you know, it's just a reflection of what's in us, you see. So what's in us is, if you don't like the world, it's a reflection of what's in you, what's in me, and it's bad. Which is why I need the blood and the life, and I need Jesus, because he's the only thing that can perfect me. And then I got to walk it out, you know. Plus, we're all scarred, you know, from abuses and things that you know, shaped our behavior, shaped our kind of, you know, psychological development, shaped us in a way that we can't change it. So I've got to have that savior, because otherwise I'm incomplete. Because I can't change some things. Huh, you too? You can't. I know you can't change some things. I can't change some things. We can't change some things. If we go to church, they'll just act, you know, they'll say, well, you cover that part of yourself up. You know, live in the closet, whatever. You know, act like you're better than that. I mean, seriously, that's what they do. Because we all have things we can't change. And that falls short of the glory of God. It falls short of the, you know, of how God wants us to be as men and women in society, that falls short of the paradigmatic model of man or woman, falls short. So the devil comes in and goes, you'll never please God. Why not just be what you are? Oh yeah, that's a very powerful argument. Why don't you just be what you are? And stop whipping yourself, and, you know, stop trying to be the perfect man or the perfect woman or the alpha male or the one. If you know, you're not like that. Just be what you are. Be honest for a change. So I have to admit, devil, you've got a good argument there. And that's all the manifestations of everything you've seen the last, you know, 30, 40 years, okay? 50 years, I'll just call it even 50. What you've seen over our society over the last 50 years is that particular attitude, that program of Satan in motion, and then the manifestation of that which is within people becomes politicized or becomes externalized in our society, our institutions, our education. And that's why, you know, you have the government doing whatever it wants and certain people above the law doing whatever they want. And you go, aren't there laws for that? Doesn't it matter? It's like, no, that's why Congress doesn't really... That's why voting doesn't matter in Congress, because they're going to do it anyway, whatever it is they want to do. Congress is just a formality. That's why people like Marco Rubio don't show up to vote, because he realizes they're going to do what they want to do anyway, and that the votes are all rigged anyway. So it's kind of a conundrum, you know, what we have. But what it is do what thou wilt has affected the last 50 years of our lives. And we are supposed to struggle with being the kind of man, the kind of woman that God wants, even if we fall short. We're not supposed to just give up and say, okay, you're right, this is within me, I can't change it. They've changed the law, so everything's cool, you know. And I'm thinking of certain social issues and things. You know what I'm saying? They want to do this across the board. Children, adults, everyone, you know, you feel like you're really a woman, and well, here you have a whole vector now that you can become a woman, and if anyone even says anything to you, if you're a man and you consider yourself a she, and they don't give you that respect of calling you she and by your girl name, woman name, $250,000 fine. I mean, it's getting more and more bizarre. But all of this goes back to do what thou wilt, and that which is against God. In other words, desecrating the holy place. And that's what happens when humans go decadent. It's because they've thrown God out. They've thrown prayer out. They've thrown God out. There's no compass. There's no absolute value to measure ourselves to or against, because it was just too hard for us, because it was just totally insensitive and intolerant of how we really are. And now we're finally behaving like we really are, and we're seeing the society based on that reflection of who we really are. So that's why they say this is the greatest America has ever been. It's the greatest, and if only we could get rid of those stick-in-the-mud evangelicals and those other people that are they're such hypocrites anyway, we would have a true utopia. And that's, you know, that's their what they envision, a true utopia based on, you know, honoring that which is within us. And that's why the children are being sexualized. You know, it's like you don't have to go to England to the Papa Kills Babies video. You got it in every school in the country now. So when they go to legalize pedophilia, and it won't be called pedophilia, it'll just be, when they go to legalize all this, and there's numbers of laws they can pass, it will already have been done, you see. So the vote is ceremonious at best and has nothing to do with what's really going on. That's the way they do everything. It's already done. They're already doing it. And then they pass a law later. It's kind of like a formality, right? But it's already a change in our society. And I know what happens to kids when they're sexually abused, which is what's going on in grade schools. They're abusing the kids. It's called abuse. It's actually called satanic ritual abuse, but they don't know they're in a ritual, right? The key is to not tell them it's a ritual. Everything's a ritual, folks. Everything. Never forget that. Never, ever, ever forget that. You got to really be vigilant now. Now, you people that are having the manifestations of gang stalking, remember that 90% of gang stalking is in your head. It's stuff that's being manipulated in your mind. Okay, let me explain. Somebody walks by you, they go, they look at you and they say a few words that are exactly what something you'd written in a post, let's say. It's there are no odds to describe it. You get freaked out, and then there's a whole litany of things going on all of a sudden. You know, now, the person that walked by you that said that had no idea of who you are, what the situation is. They just kind of inadvertently said it, and you know what? They might not have said it, but you heard it. Or, let me give you another example. You're sitting around with some people in the backyard barbecue or whatever, or at a Christmas party or whatever, or, you know, in the backyard, and there's this guy mowing the lawn next door. I guess it would be the spring, so it'd be some other kind of thing, maybe Easter. and the thing is so loud, it's starting to really disturb you, the lawnmower. You just can't handle it. But look, everybody else that you're standing around, they're acting like it's normal. Are they playing a trick on you? See? Am I on it? It's 90% psychological. They're attacking you in your mind, and that's demonic. And then what evidence there is that it's a real thing. I've seen people literally go to the Walmart parking lot and film people walking around and calling them perpetrators and acting like they have something to do in the whole thing is they don't do anything on the video that's a perp action. They don't act the way that the person is describing their acting. They have it on YouTube. And the people are just going about their business in a normal way. But in the mind of the video photographer, it's a conspiracy against them. How would they know they're in the car, that they've been following them? And it's 90% it's in your mind. It's demonic. It's a demonic attack on that person. And, you know, in this case, it was she. She's filming, and she's not getting any evidence because they're not doing anything. And I'm sorry, ma'am, but there's nothing here on this video. Another fellow contacted me on Google that was, I think, from Thailand or whatever. It looks like an American guy that's living there. I saw a video of his where he went to the police trying to document everything on video. And honestly, I'm watching the video, some of the video, and I'm not seeing what he sees, but I know it's real for him. I know it's real. Don't worry about that. I understand. And then I saw another video where he goes to the police and explains what's happening, and they say it's in your imagination. And, you know, they're half right about that. I mean, there is a physical manifestation going on and a mental, but they interact together. In your mind, you produce the story of what's really happening, but it's in your mind. I know it's hard. It's hard to see that. It's hard to admit that, but you're being attacked, definitely, but it's your mind that's being attacked. It's very sophisticated. Very sophisticated. Yes, you are targeted. But a lot of times what happens is these people get locked up in mental institutions because they start hearing things and seeing things and hearing voices, and they get labeled as schizophrenics or psychotics. But it's really an attack. But they're not either one. What they're experiencing is real, but it can't be proven. And so then they, you know, and yes, they want you to be in a mental institution, and that's the goal, to put you in a mental institution. When you get to the mental institution, by the way, then out of the clear blue sky, look, suddenly it all goes away. When you're in the mental institution, they may be giving you medication or having group therapy or whatever, and or you may be talking to counselors or seeing your doctor, but notice the whole TI thing goes away in the mental institution. It may come back at some point in there, but I'm just saying, isn't it funny? It's almost like you go in there and it's like it's the thing is lifted off you. I don't know what phenomenon that is. I don't know why that is. I know that people who have been through these things will agree with me because they've been through them. It's a horrible thing to go through. The reason it's so terrifying is because it has such, you know, it's such an onslaught on so many levels that it's impossible to fight. And, you know, for some people it gets worse and worse till they become shut-ins. There's a lot of people that are targeted that are, I'll just say, what used to be called minorities, but I mean there's a lot of people targeted because they're an angry minority, let's say, or they've been an activist in a minority, say black minority or you know, Hispanic or, you know, whatever. And sometimes they get targeted because of those political views. That's kind of that's understood. But what I'm talking about, how the mind works with it, how they're able to access to through artificial intelligence, they're able to access your mind because they've fed us stuff. They fed us. We've all been infected with certain things that you could call implants. The whole population, don't worry about it. It's the entire population. So that when they do these programs, they can target someone and trigger their mind any way they wish because they put it in Coke or Pepsi or whatever it is. You drink it, you eat it, and it's in you. And nanoparticles, whatever. It's called being infected. It's terrible. Are you kidding? It's super high technology. But it means that nobody is safe anywhere. Everybody is susceptible to being, you know, beamed, or everybody at once. It's no problem. Or all the people on the earth at the same time. It's no problem. They're all infected. You may be learning something you didn't know, or maybe you've heard this before. Now you're starting to get a little more practical understanding about things. Well, I'm sure this guy that I saw his video, he's talking to the police, and I say this with respect. He's trying to get justice, and he's trying to get his life back together, and he feels that people are consciously setting him up. And he's trying to catch them with video evidence. And it's just a real frustrating process, and I can tell he's been frustrated trying to put his case forward and having people say it's all in your mind. It's just really frustrating, because it is in his mind and it isn't. I mean, it's a very strange thing, this AI. We live in an AI environment, so you know we live in a virtual reality. So you see, they could do all kinds of things from off screen, you know, from behind their control booths, you know, to each of us. So we're all tracked. We are all tracked. We are all TIs. It's just that, you know, does the beam, the suicide beam hit all people? No, it's not hitting Barack Obama, is it? He's out playing golf, enjoying himself. The people, you know, he's got a victory in Ramadi, which some of the generals were saying, wait a second, we don't have the right policy. The day before, the head of the terrorism thing for Obama says, we don't have the right policy. The next day, a Ramadi victory? No. I got on the phone, I told my boys, you know, ISIS, which I control, get out of there. They're going to start bombing, and you guys go ahead and leave and let them think they took the city, okay? Thanks. I could use it. I'm going to get a bump on the polls from that. It's just that simple. Done. If you control both sides, you can have both, tell both sides what to do. This was a classic confirmation that ISIS is not organic because they had to be told to leave. I know they say fled. And then the papers were writing, they got routed, which was really extremely extreme exaggeration. They got routed. If there was a fight there, believe me, the Iraqis would have laid down their weapons and run away like they did before. So, I mean, this is Oceania stuff. This is right out of the book, 1984. Go ahead and refresh yourselves on that. It's the Oceania on steroids. It's just like having a false flag terror attack when you need one. Well, if you import all your boys in here, right, and you activate them all, you can have terror attack every week if you like. And there'll be bodies and people, and, you know, it's easier to kill people rather than have a fake thing, like the Sandy Hook thing was fake. I'd say if, because the evidence I've seen is 100% fake. No one died, you know, but that's the evidence I've seen. But I can't conclude because I haven't seen enough evidence. And, you know, you wonder how they cover it up. I would think it's easier to just go ahead and kill the people. If it were me, I would just say, the heck with crisis actors, just kill everybody. You know, since I'm a dictator, since I'm running the world, who cares? But it's good that they're still trying to impress people, trying to get the will of the people behind them. It's good. It shows that they still need your help out there. When they get to the point where they just do things on their own and it doesn't matter about you, then you've got a serious problem. At that point, there are no more false flags. No need. They'll tell you what they'll dictate to you, and you'll say yes, sir. Sir, yes, sir. And that will be your lot. They'll take your children from you, and you'll say, sir, yes, sir. How about with some ketchup, you know? Well, it's not funny, but it's just like, yeah, you know, living in America. What a freaking drag, man. What a horrible place this is right now. Everyone's, well, you know, okay, we do have a announcement that Lemmy, the head of Motorhead, passed away at 70 years old, and that's given me pause, like, yes, I will clean my act up. He passed away. Now, I know that he used to do a lot of crank, and I know that the whole band did. I know there's something about behind the scenes with them, which could have shortened their lives. You know, I don't think they were doing that toward the end, because nobody could last that long with it. But Motorhead, yeah. Well, there can't be a Motorhead without Lemmy. It would just, you know, he was the whole band, pretty much. He taught me how to play bass, actually. Well, when I start really pounding on the bass with lots of chords rather than, you know, just a lot of strumming, a lot of hard hitting, because I used to watch Lemmy in concert and I'd see the way he went at it, and I'm like, heck yeah, let's go at it like that. That's the way to play bass. You don't even need the guitar and drums, just have the bass. So I sort of, you know, go at it like you know, to heck with all this technique and stuff. I mean, he would just play these bar chords and, you know, you've heard Motorhead. My daughter's a fan of Motorhead. You know, I've lost touch with him over the years, I'm sorry. But he did pass away, and that brought a real pause to me, because not that, you know, we have anything in common other than music, but, you know, it was just like, wow. Motorhead was like, they were just solid. They're not gonna die. And I'm just watching people around me dying right and left. I'm like, okay, repent, reform, restore, yes. No more time to fool around. That's the message it gave to me. Well, like Obama says, he wants to squeeze every drop of change he can get out of this, you know, turning this place into a banana republic, a third world country, and that's his goal. It's like, all right, it's the same thing with my life. I mean, I'm going to go when God has his timing to go, but I'm going to give it a good shot. Yeah, I'm going to give I want to be as optimal as I can. I'm going to give a good shot to get every ounce of life I can out of it. I'm not going early. Unless God takes me, that's fine, you know. But I mean, I owe him that fight. I owe him that fight. That's why he wants us, even though I can prove it's kind of like a simulated world where we're being tested, I can prove all that. But he doesn't want us sitting on the side of the road going, oh, it's all a test. I don't really need to participate. He wants us to participate. He created it for us to participate. And participate we will. You know, I mean, is it real compared to what? Got to make it real compared to what? Bump, 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 tower power. Never mind. That was a great song. But anyway, bottom line, real compared to what? Is it real compared to what? Compared to what? Some other alternative kind of existence? You know, I mean, it's the fact that it's created is already artificial in that sense because it's been created. What, to an amorphous goo? An amorphous goo? Is that more organic for you? That has no consciousness, just kind of goo, 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 gaga. No. So it's real, right? Compared to what? Compared to anything else, it's totally real. So we call it, you know, the Truman Show and this and that. And yes, the satanic matrix within God's creation, you can call that Truman Show if you like, because that's artificial, yes. But God's creation, no, and he wants us to participate. Not everybody is trapped in the matrix. I'm not. I'm in Christ. That's my matrix. You might be in this world matrix. The world matrix spit me out. Didn't want me. So, you know, hallelujah, God made it a little easier for me. Well, they wanted me when I was maybe, you know, 5 or 6 or whatever. But then I raised such a ruckus and I caused trouble and I asked me questions. I shot my mouth off and, you know, eventually it was like, get out of here, you know. I'm like, you need to keep a secret about all these deaths and murders and all this corruption and everything just to be in the club? What are you, a moron? Your soul, and on top of that, you give up your soul? You become somebody else? Like my friend, from my boyhood friend would go visit him and he's like some kind of robot. Some kind of sock puppet. And the him was gone that I used to know. And the same thing with classmates, looking at them at a 40-year reunion. 40 years. I mean, this just shows how the clock is ticking on me, folks. It's ticking. It's ticking. 40-year reunion. And it was like watching a funeral, like watching no festivities at all. It was like watching the... a video footage from a reception of a funeral. You know how you have a funeral, then you have a reception afterwards, and people, you know, drink a lot, and they say they're going to see you next year. You know, it was like that. It was just really, and the reason is no one had any energy. You know, it's like, what happened to you people? And the answer is, well, you know, they did it. They didn't do it their way. They did it the world's way, and it's just. They wound up really not even totally there. And then the friend that did tell me about that, who sought me out on Facebook, then he wound up dying like with a year later after seeking me out. No, it was 2011, so it'd be 2 years later. I mean, in 2011, I did a song called 1111. It was kind of, you know, that's when Jonathan Cleck was predicting the dam at Hoover Dam was going to break and all that. Remember that back in 11? 1111, I did a song, 1111, I don't know where it is right now. Awesome, back then. Did some awesome music back then. 2011, it's 2015. Look how it's flying. Oh, man. I gotta have to dig out all that music and put it somewhere, and I'm thinking I've got a strategy. Anyway, back to... The feeling bad today. When you come out of this, you will thrive. You will have a real long run. But it's going to come back. I can tell you when. I don't know exactly when Easter is, but it's coming back around that time. the same horrible, horrible demonic crap. And in 2016, Easter will be the advent of the whole UFO thing, and they're going to try to blend it with Christ. I already see the orbs now in the church thing. So we got all kinds of things on the docket for next year. I mean, they are going to roll out the UFO thing at some point, but usually, you know, like when I saw Madonna and Child photo yesterday, I saw this, and I forget the artist, and I apologize for that, but there was a UFO in the background of a Madonna and Child painting. And then if you look with a magnifying glass, you'll see there's somebody standing there looking at the UFO in the sky. And then there's some kind of being that's not an alien, but it's like a shape of these things flying around. And it was that shape was on the clothing of the Madonna. And you know, NASA has adapted that same vector shape in their logo, and then every space agency has. And it's something that's giving honor to some sort of being. You know, and I don't know if they can shapeshift into like a humanoid or, you know, when we interact with aliens, it's like we see a, you know, a bipedal creature, right? Something we can relate to, right? It's really just a confabulation of what we need to see, yes? You understand that, right? So there are things that are just inexplicable, and one would be these kind of shapes or whatever that you know, have been filmed before. And, you know, it may go along with being orbs or whatever, but I think whatever this thing is, it has kind of a vector shape, but it's like, it's not like a V vector thing exactly. It's a kind of like almost some sort of thing that, it, you know, and it's not a UFO. I don't know what it is. I should really look into it more and try to talk about it from a bit more of, you know, being a bit more educated on it. I'm just going by my feeling right now that this, you know, that a lot of this whole space alien thing comes from this reality, you know, and it's a fiction. And the whole, it's all kind of existing in another dimension, but is that going to be interacting with us? It's like, they can't, okay, I'm saying, wait, they can't just roll it out whenever they feel like it. It's all scheduled, you know, by beyond human, you know, so it's by God, I suppose. So it'll be rolling out, you know, in its time, but me thinks that 2016 is going to be a lot of stuff rolled out, and, you know, when you see the alien thing rolled out, you'll be at least aware that it's just simply demons, right? You're not going to fall for the alien thing, right? Take me to your planet. You're not going to fall for that, right? Because you see, these things, if you let them, you know, run amok, they will, you know, these are beings. And they will, you know, try to control your life. And they will tell you lies. And they will tell you things about yourself that are not true, to get you to act in a manner that you would not ordinarily act in. What did I tell you about the litmus test? When you're acting in a way that you wouldn't ordinarily act in, you got witchcraft on you. So that's the epitome of, that's where the witchcraft comes from. That's the interact. That's the power they're drawing from. And at the same time, they're setting those things loose on the population so that they can have control. And you think, well, is there a powerful coven? Well, there is, actually. These are the ones that do the bloodlines. I mean, that's the top. There's the queen of heaven, you know, which is the queen of the matrix, really. There's the queen of, you know, people say it's Semiramis or whatever. You know, I don't want to go ahead and name it. I'll just say there's, you know, these covens sort of, you know, are formed in as a grand circle around the one, right? And the one is the one that, you know, guides the earth. And Satanism is really a queendom. You know, the satanic world is a queendom. And all the unholy acts and all the unholy stuff, it comes from that circle. I call it the circle of shame, you know, around the queen. And the queen, people say, well, that's the mother goddess you're talking about. It's like, you know, whatever. You can call it Satan if you like, or mother goddess. It doesn't matter. It's the same thing. It's to say whatever people need. Another, you need a female deity? Fine. You need male? Fine. You need horns? Fine. You need Baphomet? Fine. You need but it's the same program. And so a lot of these women that get into this thing, they then realize how easy it is to enslave the men, right, with the powers they have, and so they keep it quiet. And then they get, you know, as many men, the goal is to get them enslaved. And then from this queendom comes the assignment of a different, you know, the doling out of jobs and, you know, titles and, you know, president and prime minister and, you know, world history. It sort of flows from that. And if you would like to call the queendom the matrix, you're more than welcome to. Go right ahead. You would be spot on. But it's very, very multidimensional, and it's very, very, it's just so bizarre. And with men, you know, it's easy. You just get control of the little head, so the little head is ruling the big head, and you bring them in, right? And, you know, then, you know, you tame them so that all their effort, all their orgasms, all their killing, everything, all their thoughts go into this hive and are orchestrated by, you know, if you like, if we want to switch metaphors, we'd call it the dragon. So you breathe in, you breathe out, you feed the dragon feeds you. If you want to look at it that way, fine. Or the buddy system, we're cut off from God, we need a source of power. You know, we can do the buddy system of breathing, like we're underwater sharing the aqualung. I think someone did a song called Aqualung about someone with their own air supply, and what a horrible tragedy befell them. Yeah, funny, Mr. Anderson, but the entire Mr. Ian Anderson of England, of the CIA, I'm sorry, MI6. By the way, the entire world to not understand that Aqualung lyric. They just dug the music and they went along with it. So funny, we see Jethro Tull out, you know, recently on, has been touring, I mean, over the last 3 or 4 years, you know what I mean? That's what I mean by recently. And they play it just like the record. They're perfect performing seals. You know, what a horrible tragedy to have to go out and you know, when you're having trouble breathing, or, you know, you're old and you're having to do this this tour, you know, it's just really sad to me, because what I would want to do if I were in a position like that and had made a lot of money and a lot of success, you know, in writing, because I figured the public will never understand the lyrics anyway, we'll just mind control them with it, you know. What I would do is I would play a whole new set of material for the folks. Yeah. But that would get him killed, wouldn't it? Then he'd be worth more dead than alive. If you were to take that attitude, you know, the cowboy drives the buggy. I hope you understand that. And I don't care whether you're Ian Anderson or Steven Spielberg or anybody of these, you know, or Warren Buffett, you got to let the cowboy drive that buggy or you're going to get thrown out. You ain't going to be able to bask in your billions of dollars or your prior victories in music or directing films or whatever. Those days are just, you know, if the cowboy says you're out, according to David Lynch, who's, you know, basically trying to confess through his cowboy imagery. Oh, it didn't stop there. It showed up in another film called The Big Empty. The cowboy was there too. Yeah, he drives the buggy. You're in the buggy as long as you keep your mouth shut and keep your attitude on straight. You'll be okay. The minute you start acting up, you're going to have an untimely suicide. Oh, there's that word again, suicide. Well, who's mad at you, baby? Who's mad at you? Could it be the cowboy? You're not exactly cooperating. Well, you've done a good job then. But this suicide idea is not yours. He's trying to get you to do that. So don't let him. on your best day, where everything's going really well, you know, then try to make a case for killing yourself. You won't be able to do it. But that would be legitimately, if you don't want to be a hypocrite, that's when you'd have to do it, on your best day, when things are going really well. Otherwise, you doing it now would be completely false, because it would be someone else's idea. It wouldn't be you. I guess you could say, I'm a victim of a hit and run. You could justify it that way, maybe. But then if you know that, I've already told you that, you can't wiggle out of it. No. The only thing you can do is take a deep breath, wipe your mind clean of all that stuff, and walk on with the rest of us. Walk this thing out. Better days are ahead. And I'm warning you already, how many months in advance of Easter? I'm warning you right now, it's going to be a rough one at that time. I'm warning you right now. We're going in some tough time, but it's going to be so theatrical. You got to stick around to see what's going to happen. I mean, it's wild. Nobody knows. Used to be, you know, the powers that be, the Doc Fulces, they had everything planned out, what they were going to do, what they weren't going to. They have the Bilderberg meeting, they divide up the world. And now nobody knows what's going to happen. Nobody, not them, nobody. Nobody, there's no plan. There is no plan. Oh, there is a plan. I mean, a short-term plan. That was to wipe out ISIS and bring John Wayne back to and they can't stand it. It's either that or become a parking lot. I'm sticking with that word. You know, when it repeats like that and it doesn't change, it doesn't get embellished, it's kind of right? You know, it's got that ring of truth, that feel that I have to have. So I'm going to stick with it. I'm just going to say that's what it looks like. And there's this kind of game to make it look like they're crapping on ISIS and getting them. But it's really kind of like fake combat, right? And, you know, what I'm amazed with is that all this information is out now and almost mainstream. You know, and they're still doing it. Like, it's like everything's a false flag. Okay, so they're still doing it? They figure the rest of the people are so dumb they can still get away with it. Like Democrats are so stupid they can get away with it. Well, Republicans are stupid too. I mean, they can get away with it, right? The establishment of Republicans and Democrats are the same party, basically. We understand that. But then God sent along Donald Trump. Highly unlikely blood and guts guy. Who says what he wants to say. And, you know, and he doesn't care about Anonymous. He doesn't care about any of these groups. He doesn't care about what being politically incorrect. He doesn't care about, you know, this whole thing, oh, you can't say that about Muslims. It's like, yeah, you pull the visas until you get a plan together, and then you you open up the process again. That's all. There's absolutely nothing wrong with that. There's nothing racist about that. There's nothing hateful about that. So Anonymous in this case is wrong, but who corrects Anonymous? Anyway, God has favor on him, whatever the outcome. I mean, he might bow out of the race. Ted Cruz could win Iowa. The next thing you know, that he's you know going on a losing streak, so he decides to clip his losses and throw his support to Cruz and bow out, or he could double down and start spending. What's he going to spend? $100 million plus on ads this week? Oh boy. Oh boy. And you better believe with a guy like him, he'll get twice the mileage out of those ads that Jeb Bush got, right? He'll get a good deal. And that's what we need as America. We need a good deal, and we need to crush political correctness, and we need to crush the left and all the things the left does. You know, they go, well, Donald Trump was on the left. No, he was a classical Democrat, you know, Republican, whatever side, you know, he knew both sides were kind of the same, and he was playing, you know, doing the real estate game. He said he was part of the establishment. He confessed it. It's not like he's hiding something. And, you know, he has some liberal ideas and some conservative ideas. He's not 100% conservative or whatever, but most Republicans are liberals. In the progressive sense of the word, meaning the more totalitarian sense. And so the party, Donald Trump, single-handedly destroyed the Republican Party. I give him all the credit for that destruction. Hallelujah. How awful it was when I had to hold my nose and vote for Romney, and then I watched him throw the debate on purpose because he was told to by his handlers, by the people above him who wanted to make sure Obama had a nice ride. Like, no matter what Obama does wrong, they cover it all up for it. It's disgusting watching it, actually. The thing that's even more sick is he believes his own press. The press for Obama is bought and paid for. They're just propaganda outlets, but he believes it. See, that's the thing that I worry about. He believes that he's a good president. He believes that he's worked hard. He believes that you know, all he's done is he's just a politico doing his political bickering and keeping track of people that he doesn't like and whatnot. You know, petty stuff. He hasn't done anything. Yeah. He proved to the world that he is the commander-in-chief of ISIS. That he proved, that it was command and control. And everyone's making that leap. Everyone knows that now. It's not like Al-Qaeda. It's way more hands-on for the president. He literally has hands-on on this thing. He literally sends the leaflets down to tell the, I mean, he does it in your face. It's completely illegal, by the way. He could be thrown in jail forever based on ISIS. They all could be. It's 100% wrong, but then so are false flag attacks. So is all the rest of it. Will he get caught? Will Congress get caught? Will there be an accounting? Will people go to jail for breaking the law? Well, in the environment we're in, all the truth is going to come out in 2016 about everything. Even 9/11 will get a big boost in 2016. The floodgates are about to open. The information is about to go mainstream. The shameful, you know, liars at Fox News and CNN and MSNBC are being outed right and left, and they will be rewarded with no ratings whatsoever. None. Zero. It's, you know, they really appeal, like Fox News appeals to, like, your parents who were, you know, conservatives. Right? And so they're, you know, and they're in their 60s and 70s, and they're watching Megyn Kelly, who's really young and blonde, and they believe every word of it, you know? And that's who it appeals to. It doesn't appeal to young people. They're not watching Fox News. Fox News has no audience going forward. It's all these people going to die. And they have no backup plan. Well, they're just cheap propagandists and apologists for the satanic world system. That's what they're there for. To make you think they're God-fearing and conservative and have American values, so you'll tune in. But they're just basically hypnotizing you, lulling you to sleep, and then they turn the tables on you on, like, 10% information's wrong, or the, you know, there's ISIS is a real organic entity. Obama, of course, is a patriot. He's got nothing to do with it. These are all the lies we've caught them doing, and on and on and on with their lies. I mean, they lie every day. I used to watch them fervently, and I still watch, like, Fox Business quite a bit. I rather watch the economics because that tells me more about what's going on. And from the economic side, I have a little more hope than most people in the future of the economy. I've been hearing gloom and doom every year that I can remember. Every year I get the propaganda for gloom and doom. Every year it's going to be the worst depression of all time. I go back to following the economy since the 70s, okay? And since, like, the early 70s, watching the financial channel, like Channel 28 in Los Angeles, and remember that? And all that. I've been watching economics and finance for as long as I can remember. And they're always talking about the next depression, the gloom and doom, the blah, blah, blah. You know, it's been the same as it is now the whole way through. And never have I heard, like, you know, that's the problem with conspiracy channels, with alternative media. They always have negative news on the economy. And you know, yes, there's a way to look at it that way. But how do you explain the fact that it's gone for this long? I actually see some glimmers of hope. But I also see the powers that be and the Masonic societies and so forth, preventing the outflow of new technologies, preventing it so that the economy doesn't do good, slowing down the pipeline at Apple, slowing down the pipelines of new innovations and inventions and things with energy and all that, slowing down to a crawl so that they can arrest growth and keep it at 1-2%, which is the plan of this particular powers that be, is their plan to choke the people and choke the people and choke the people while it looks like you've saved the economy and keep putting surreptitiously these people on the dole, those people on the dole, get them all dependent, and then pull the plug, and then you got them, right? Done, you won. And there's just something that's pushing back against that, which is the bright spot, I say. As far as Donald Trump, I believe that he should, based on the numbers and popularity, he should be able to clinch the nomination and go on. And of course, you know, with Hillary, what I get is this: they will pull out all the stops on cheating at the polls, and if there are not watchdog groups on every single precinct, then that will be a precinct that goes to Hillary Clinton, whoever the nominee is. I mean, I'm not saying it should be Trump, but see, they got so many dirty tricks up their sleeve now that I'm not sure that's going to happen. Look what they did to Romney. You know, he was going to run, and they made him. Obama was saying, you know, was insulting him, and he had to sit there and take it. He could have continued trouncing him, but they told him to shut up. You know, Obama's the guy, he was told. And now it's just a different ballgame. It's like, you know, there's a new sheriff in town, and that sheriff is saying equilibrium. He's not saying, they're not interested in the Albert Pike plan. And that's our best hope, folks. I don't know who these people are. I don't know where they come from. I don't know where they live. I don't even know if they're human. But they're there. And then you've seen what I've said, manifestations of what I've said come true, right? Which when it was said, it was out of the clear. I mean, it was like, you're insane. Everyone else was saying something else, right? So it truly was something, you know, and we've seen a follow-through with it. So if it's God that's doing it and the angels, then I'd say, well, that which God is doing, he's not going to fail at, right? It's like Donald Trump has supernatural protection. It seems like they're so nasty to him, you know, online, but then it seems like then there's, all of a sudden, it just goes the other way. And they're so nasty to him online, and then it goes the other way, doesn't it? It's like, you know, they say this about him, that about him. They show his wife in a semi-nude photo or whatever, and they show, you know, they're calling him a fascist. It's like, no, he's not a fascist. You have fascists already in power. You know, Obama's a fascist. You know, technically, what Donald Trump is he is a free market capitalist. That is the opposite of fascism. He wants the middle class to rise again, and entrepreneurship to rise again. He wants all boats to rise economically. I mean, that's his stated purpose. But the left will try anything, any kind of term, fascist. You know, there's one guy that's got a site called Fascist for Trump, where he's got Trump with a swastika on his forehead. He's always chiming in as a tweet. Twitter. I mean, you know, and I look at them, the left. This is all the left. And I'm like, my God, you know, throwing God out of your life and becoming a Satanist, which is what they've all done. That's why they behave that way. You know, it comes from the spirit, right? They're all down. Yeah, they're all initiated and indoctrinated, and it's not a political indoctrination. Thank you very much. It's a political manifestation of a spiritual indoctrination, and that's how the left has always been run by Satanists, right? It's the left, you know, the left and the right. The right's supposed to be righteous, but the right sold out to Satan too. So you got the right and the left both on the left, basically, technically. And there really is no right now, but there is some kind of, you know, thing happening that's very interesting. Well, I'm being objective because I may be also a free market capitalist. I'm kind of more of a libertarian. I've smaller government. I'm all fine with letting marijuana people out of jail and all that stuff. I'm, you know, more libertarian. But libertarian just means, you know, it's just kind of a common sense. You know what I mean? You have the government you have. You don't go off to foreign wars. You don't have all these secret societies running everything or special interests. You cut all that. And, you know, you have a government that serves the people, not serving the special interests on the taxpayer's dime. You know, all that has to stop. So that would be more libertarian, which would be just honesty and integrity and a set of morals that that the Congress and the presidency should follow, which they don't follow now. They're completely illegal and wrong, but there's no one to arrest them because there's nobody enforcing the law. The inmates are truly running the asylum at this point. The American people are held hostage. What they say, what they want to do, it doesn't really matter. The reason they push the left agenda, the PC thing, is because they want to overthrow Western civilization. It's got nothing to do with making it nice here for people. They don't care. Hey, I voted, you know, for the Communist Party when I was young. I mean, I'm, you know, it's a progression, right? You know, I was all about restoring the land to the Indians, and I was like that in the Zeff Report back 10 years ago as well. Until I did a little more research, and I found the Indians bludgeoning each other to death, and the whole thing, no romantic notion of the Indians on American soil. And, you know, as you poke through each of these things, you start kind of wising up, and now I realize, that which wants to officially throw God out of our society, what party do they belong to? No, just bear with me. What party do they belong to? It's always the Democrats. Right? So that would be the party of Satan. Because they want to throw God out, and they want to put the Baphomet statues in, and they want to enforce this whole PC thing and do what thou wilt. And they want to corrupt all the children, abuse them, and you know, shape their behavior so they take their place as sex objects in the New World Order. I mean, you know, and slaves and whatnot. You know, distribute the talents, or, you know, they want to control everything by the state. This is all satanic. So I would say Satanist, because it's a manifestation of their spiritual values, which are that which is against God, are their values. You know, I mean, I figured it out. Most people go, it's the same thing. It's like, there's not a dime's bit of difference between the two parties, and you're just out of your mind. I'm like, I didn't say that. You didn't hear me right. I'm saying the philosophy of the left, basically, and the behavior and the laws implemented and the things they want to do shows me Satanism. I could say the same thing about the Communist Party, and the Socialist Party that gave rise to Adolf Hitler, all come from the same left-wing perspective, which to me is ultimately fascism, although there is right-wing fascism, which is monopolies of capitalists to get control of government by the corporate. Oh, you mean controlling the government by the corporation is fascism? Yes, that's technically it. Oh, well, then we have fascism. Yes, that's right. We have fascism right now. And Donald Trump wants to get rid of fascism. You know, the old boy crony capitalist network wants to get rid of that and have a more even keel and have Americans prosper. Right now, the powers that be that are there now, they don't want Americans to prosper. They want to limp along and to change the fundamental paradigm of how the world works, meaning a top-down hierarchical approach, which is, by the way, nothing new. That's how the world's been run for thousands of years. You know, America was exceptional in the fact that it was against that system earlier on. But then the people got corrupted here. But, when I see a guy like Michael Moore, I think he's a fascist, obviously. He's like a bully thug who wants his way. And, you know, it's anything that is that which is against God. If you don't agree with that which is against God, he wants to bludgeon you with it, knowing that he's protected by the government, who is run by the, you know, the global elite or whatever. Fascistic. I don't need to really research it. I'll leave it up to the experts. That's where a guy like Jordan Maxwell really did do a good job. The Zeitgeist thing, I'm not really into that, but... I'm going to have to say one last thing about the Jewish thing. You know, I don't like to really, you know, ban people or whatever, but I'll just say this in the hopes that some people hear it. I'm not into the Jew thing. And I'm not into that, you know, I post something about my video and they say that most of the people in there are Israelis. You know, the Israelis and the Mossad are really, you know, they're trying to get the contemporary Jew today, not the Zionists, but the just Jews in Israel, Israelis, as being a big part of the problem and part of the conspiracy, and almost to the point of ignoring any other facts. First of all, the Jew thing is a false psyop. And it's being run by certain people, and I know, I've been through the whole thing for years now. I mean, for, you know, a dozen years now, I've been through this thing. And I can just tell you that it's just like the people that go after the Vatican have the Vatican for everything. It's the Jesuits are at the root of all evil. They're all wrong. So I don't share that. It's not that I don't mind people doing research into stuff like that and trying to connect the dots. It's a waste of my time. The bottom line is the ruler of this world, of this present darkness, is Satan and the minions of Satan and all that. The people that serve him are Satanists. They're no longer Jews. They're not Catholics. They're not Christians. They're not Muslims. They're Satanists, okay? If we could just keep it on that simple level, then I'd appreciate it. Well, you know, they can't get off the Jew thing. You know, and so now they're saying... They're trying to conjecture that the reason they have all the masks on is because a lot of them are Israelis. Well, Israelis wouldn't look much different from the Arabs that are there, if that's what it is. I think it's a mix. I believe that the people serving the ISIS thing, are, you know, a lot of these are mercenaries from around the world. And the reason the masks don't come off is some of these people you may recognize as Americans. But not Americans that just joined up. They're Americans who are mercenaries, who are ex-military, whatever, who signed up because they're getting paid good. I know it's sick. You know, that's. Let's focus on that part of it rather than it's the Jews. Don't do that, please. That just you have more intelligence than that. There's a lot more to it than that. There are people that are trying to sway you with propaganda to turn against the Jews or turn against this or that. And it wasn't enough to have the Rothschilds and the Zionists, you know. Now we're after the young Israelis. They're the, you're right. And so it really is the Jews. They say, well, I'm not anti-Jewish, I'm anti-Zionist. No, you're anti-Jew. And you use that Zionist versus the real Jew thing. Then the next thing is, well, they're all converts. They're all Khazar Jews or whatever, this... you know, and these kind of Jews, they're not the real Jews. The real Jews are, you know, the real Jews came from Africa. Or what, and I'm just like, please stop. Don't do this. It's a snare. It's a waste of your time. But if I keep having to encounter it on my channels, I will start deleting those. It doesn't mean anything against you personally. It's just I'm not going to go there. Because there's a lot of people that would entice to chime on in and you know, and co-opt my threads or, hijack any thread. Because once you get into that stuff, then the original intent of the video or the posting or whatever is lost. It's like you just focus on that and not on the information or the content that I posted. And I'm not going to allow threads to be hijacked by the Jew thing. So it's fair warning, and if you don't hear it here in the podcast, I might, you know, couple of you I may write privately and just say, you know, I'm not going there. But it's almost like they there's some kind of sickness with that. It's like this need to shame everybody that doesn't really go along with it as being part of the Zionist conspiracy or whatever. And it's just such an insult to me that I can't get them off it. Then if you don't like that, they got the serpent seed doctrine, and they roll that out on you. There's just no end to it. The Jews are of the devil. Their father is the devil, and that's who they serve, and they kill children in the basement, and they sell the meat to McDonald's. You know, they run the entertainment business. They're all perverts, or whatever. Have you seen the Talmud, what they want to do to Jesus and what they allow with little children? And that's where all the pedophilia came from. It came from the Jews. No. When Jesus said this is the synagogue of Satan, he means hypocrites, which there are just as many in the Christian church. So where do you want to draw the line about pointing the finger at people? If you really want the real information, it's us, and out of the pool of us, you know, beyond our religions, but now they're going to keep going, well, the Jews are of Cain, and that's of the devil, that's the serpent seed. In other words, their father is the devil, the Jews. And it's like, what's your point? I know what the point is. They want to exterminate them. That's what they want. Because they're like an abomination worse than the Philistines. You know, the hybrids. They are hybrids. And, you know, it goes on from there, but I see when you come around with that sort of thing, I think you're in the CIA. You know, I think you're a shill. Because who would want to hijack threads? Shills. What would be the reason? To get off the original information that was presented there. So I'm not going to allow it, all right? Fair warning. And with that, I bid you to wrap it up. There'll be no suicide today, or any day ever for you. I'll still call this the suicide beam because, you know, I think they jumped the shark on this one. You know, I think that this thing's going to lift a lot faster than, you know, even before New Year's, so, which is basically 2 days away. Okay, I'll see you next time.